Today we're going to talk about how to install the RepRap Discount Smart Controller on the Bigtree Tech SKR Pro version 1.2. So I'm going to point out a couple of obvious things on the front of the LCD. As you can see right here, we have our LCD, and then to select menus, you can turn this and then push down to select. We also have a piezo buzzer that's underneath this sticker, as well as a stop button, which I believe acts like a reset button. Then we have our EXP 1 and 2 for our ribbon cables to connect over here, as well as an SD card. Now, one note, currently the Marlin version that we're working with has an issue with the SD drive on here compared to here, so reading a G-code file might be an issue. They're currently working on it. So I'm just going to show you how to set up the LCD and talk about it a little bit. But first thing we need to find out is where the EXP ports are. We know they're here, but I want to show you how to see it in the manual. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to the browser for a second, and we're going to see what it looks like. So on the browser, as you can see right here, what we need to do is actually configure it for our particular configuration. So over here, you can see that we're going to have to click on the Bigtree Tech SKR Pro, which is the preceding board, and then SKR Pro over here. So there's several different folders. They put a sample for their Wi-Fi right here. They also talk about their virtual port. I'm not going to cover any of that, but I'll show you what the manual looks like in just a moment. So basically the manual will outline what you can work with, but there are other things in this folder that might be of interest to you. And those may be, for instance, the pins file. This will tell you where all the pins are. And so maybe we can try that real quick and see what happens. So I'm going to click on the pins, and apparently there's a little bit of a lag today. So we're just going to click on download so we can see it. So over here we have EXP1 and EXP2. So now we know where they're located. So we're just going to go back over to the workbench, and we're going to see if we can get this to work. So I'm going to flip this over. And as you can see, it says EXP1. So I'm going to take the notched connector and I'm going to connect it like so. Then I'm going to place this down here for a second and use the notched connector again to connect it down here. So that's EXP1. Now EXP2 is going to be the same, a notched connector. We'll put it in here. And then I'm going to slide it down underneath here and place it in as well. So to test this, to make sure that it works correctly, we're actually going to put the jumper over here that would normally be in PSU power, which is these two pins, over to the two pins to the right. And that'll allow us to power it with USB. So I'm going to plug it in. And as you can see, it does power up. So now that we have that sorted out, we need to load firmware. So I'm going to unplug this for a moment, and I'm going to place the SD drive in my USB converter so that we can actually load the files. So I'm going to plug it in here and slide it down, and I'm going to place this in the computer. And just so you know, no one is paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. And one last thing, when you're actually running steppers, this needs to be in the PSU position, which would be over here, so that you're running off your power supply unit. But for this particular tutorial, I'm trying to show you how to use the LCD, and we only need 5 volts of power. So let's go over to VS Code. And inside VS Code, what we need to do is actually go to the Explorer, which I'll show you a little bit better in 2 seconds. So over here you can see Explorer. Then we're going to go to Open Folder. Then we're going to go to our Downloads folder. And I've already downloaded the Marlin firmware that we're going to be working with and extracted it. So I'm going to click on this, then the second Marlin, then I'm going to select the folder. Inside the selected folder, we'll get all of the things we need to actually set it up. So we're going to go to Marlin, then we're going to go to Source Core Boards.h, and we're going to search on SKR underscore Pro, and that'll bring us to the board that we're looking for, which is the 1.2. So we'll highlight it and then copy it. Then we'll minimize Core and Source, go to configuration.h, and search on motherboard. Here we'll place what we just copied over the ramps. And then we'll change our serial port to -1. And now what we need to do is actually set up our LCD. But before I do that, I want to show you some stuff that you can configure. So I'm going to search on SD or LCD and SD support. LCD and SD. And this will bring us to the actual section where we can configure stuff. So as you can see, you have a language setting that you can set. So there's obviously English. There's Poliska, Ukrainsk, Ruska, Espanol, Afrancais, and many others. And you can also add your own. But for now, I just wanted to point that out so that you can configure it to your comfort level. Down here, we have a choice of different alphabets, I guess. So we have Japanese, Western, or Cyrillic. And then we have a type of LCD that we can use, being either classic or Prusa. Then you can see there's SD support. If you want to use it, you need to remove the comment. But for now, we're not going to use it. And then we have cyclical redundancy check, which is SD check and retry. This will keep trying if there's an issue. And when I said CRC, it's right here why I'm saying cyclical redundancy check. So we also have some other settings that we can set on here. I'll let you experiment with these. Most of these are just movements of like the potentiometer for choosing menus. That's that little dial that you can select menus with, and you can control which way it goes. There's a buzzer that we can enable, which is right here. They call it a speaker, but it's the piezo buzzer. So most of that is just stuff you can play with. So I'm going to actually set up the LCD now. So I'm going to search on rep_discount, and here it is. So to enable this, you're going to remove the comment. So now we need to set it up to actually build. So we're going to go over to platformio.ini, and inside here you can see that the default environment is for the Mega 2560 chipset. So we have to find ours. So I'm going to search on SKR underscore Pro, and that'll bring us to our environment. So I'm going to copy that, then I'm going to scroll to the top, and I'm going to paste it over that environment. So that's all you have to do to set it up. Now, there's one thing I want to show you that I've probably shown many times before now, but there's a .pio folder. As you can see, it's got the Mega 2560 in there. To clean that out so that we have less compiler issues, we're going to click the little garbage can for clean. So now it's gone. We're going to actually click the checkbox to build. Now, this may fail on the first try or may not. If it does, compile it a second time by pressing the build button for the checkbox. If it actually fails a third time, then go to the very first error that you see and correct that, because the other ones might be caused by a cascade of errors from the first one. So this is what it looks like in the .pio at the moment. You can see that it says build, then it has our board type. And then over here, you can see that it's created the firmware.bin down here. So to move this over to what we're working with, we're gonna go to Reveal in Explorer, and then we're gonna right click again, and we're gonna send it to our D drive. On our D drive, you can see there's a firmware.bin in lowercase, and there's also a firmware.cur in capital letters. The cur was the current one. If the firmware.bin loads without issue, it'll rename itself to this. So let's go back to the desktop. And what we're going to do is we're going to remove the drive. We're going to then place it in here. And we're going to power the system. And as you can see, the blinking green light is loading the firmware. And now it shows the actual menu and the version number. So we can click on this and select menus if we so choose. And that's how it works. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.